So another consideration we might want to think about with decision trees, which you're not going to go into a lot of detail, but I think might be worth at least mentioning, is the problem of regression. So far we've only been doing classification, where the outputs are discrete, but what if we were trying to solve something that looked more like x squared or 2x plus 17 or some other continuous function? In other words, a regression problem. How would we have to adapt decision trees to do that? Any ideas, Michael?
So these are now continuous outputs, not just continuous inputs.
Right. Maybe the outputs are all continuous. Maybe the outputs are discrete. Maybe they're a mix of both.
Well, it certainly seems like our rule of using information gain is going to run into trouble because it's not really clear how you measure information on these continuous values. So I guess you could measure error some other way. It's not error, right? It's trying to measure how mixed up things are. Oh, so maybe something like variance? Because in a continuous space, you can talk about, you know, if there's a big spread in the values, that would be measured by the variance.
Oh, good. So what you really have here now is a question about splitting. What's the splitting criteria?
Maybe. And I guess there's also an issue of what you do in the leaves.
Right. So what might you do in the leaves?
I guess you could do some sort of more standard kind of fitting algorithm. So like report the average or do some kind of linear fit.
There's any number of things you could do here. By the way, that's worth pointing out on the output that if we do pruning like we did before, we have errors. We didn't actually say when we talked about that how you would report an output, right? If you don't have a clear answer where everything is labeled true or everything is labeled false, how do you pick? So something like an average would work there.
I don't know. I mean, it seems like it depends on what we're trying to measure with the tree. If the tree is we're trying to get as many right answers as we can, then you probably want to do like a vote in the leaves.
Right, which at least if the only answer is true or false, that would look a lot like an average, I guess. Right, so you do a vote. I like that. So we do vote. So if we do pruning, we do have to deal with this issue of the output somehow. And something like a vote makes sense. And here, when you have a regression, then I guess average is a lot like voting.
Yeah, in a continuous space.
Yeah. So either way, we're doing a kind of voting. I like that.